Hi friends, in this video I am going to explain about the concept of current division rule. Okay, so this is the very important rule we are going to use in the electrical circuit calculations. Okay, so actually when we are going to use this particular current division rule in the electrical circuits, so basically this is used when the current is divided into different branches. Okay, for example we have one circuit like this. So this is R1, R2, R3, if suppose. Now what happened? Definitely some amount of current is flowing. So up to this point we have only resistance. So that's why same amount of current is flowing from up to this point. But after this point we have two different branches. R2 is one path and R3 is another path. It means depending upon the values of resistances, current is divided into two parts. Yes or no? If suppose this is I1, then this is I2, this is I3. Okay, just I am giving the names. Okay, so I2 is a current which is flowing in the R2 branch and I3 is a current which is flowing in R3 branch. So in this cases, if you want to find the values of this particular current divided or this particular divided current I2, or if you want to find the current divided, that is I3 in particular R3 branch. So if we want to find these divided currents in the circuit, then we are going for the current division rule. Okay, so this is a very, very important rule we are going to use in the calculations of electrical circuits. Okay, so first just see. So current division rule. Okay, so just see here. So I am taking one circuit. R1, this is R2, and the last one, this is R3. So this is DC voltage. Now R1, R2, R3 are the three resistances and this is the node point. Clear? Now some amount of current is flowing in the circuit, that is I1, if suppose. Okay, so I1 is the current which is flowing from supply to this point. So totally, actually this current is flowing in the total circuit, but up to this point there is no disturbance. It means what? Same, whatever the current is flowing, that is I1 in the circuit. But what happened when this current is reaches to this point and what happened after this particular node point? So just see, already we know that current is always chooses low resistance path. Yes or no? So current is always chooses low resistance path, but in this network we have two different resistances, R2 and R3. It means depending upon the values of resistances, current is also divided. It means what? If suppose depending upon the value of resistance, the divided current is I2, I am just considering, and here also some amount of current is divided depending upon the value of resistance. Clear? Now in this case, this divided current I2 in R2 branch and this divided current I3 in R3 branch. So these two currents are divided from the total current I1. Now in this case, if we want to find the value of I2, that is divided current I2, then we are going to use current division rule. Or if we want to get the value of current I3 or divided current I3 from this circuit, so we are going for the current division rule. But how we can find the value of I2 or I3 from this circuit? That is the concept. Okay, just see here. So I2 is a divided current, I3 is also divided current. From what? I1. It means if you want to get the value of I2 or I3 from this circuit, first we need to find the value of current I1 in the circuit. So what is the formula? Actually, what is the formula to get the value of total current in the circuit? So that is actually I is equal to V divided by R. So this is used to find the value of total current in the circuit. But we need to find the value of I2 and I3 from this circuit. It means if you want to get the values of these two currents, divided currents, first we need to find the value of total current. It means I1 is equal to V divided by R, where R is what? Equivalent. It means we need to get the parallel combination of these two, and after getting the resultant of this parallel combination, again this is connected in series with the value of R1. It means we can directly get the value of equivalent resistance. That is, so these two are connected in parallel, means what? R2 into R3 divided by R2 plus R3, and the resultant of this parallel combination is again connected in series with the value of R1. It means I am writing like this, R1 plus R2 into R3 divided by R2 plus R3. If suppose we are having the values of resistances, just substitute here and applied voltage. If suppose we are having the applied voltage 10, and if suppose the value of R1 is 1 ohm, R2 is also 1 ohm, R3 is also 1 ohm, if suppose, then directly we will get the values of what? Total current in the circuit. That is 10 divided by 1 plus 1 into 1 divided by 1 plus 1. That is equal to 10 divided by, so 1 plus 1 into 1, 1 divided by 2. How much? 1 by 2. It means 0.5. That is equal to 10 divided by 1.5. So this is the value of total current in the circuit, that is I1. Now after getting this total current from the circuit, now we are going for the values of calculation of what? I2 and I3. But how we will get the values of I2 and I3 means we have one formula. That is the value of I2, that is calculation of I2, is equal to total current into opposite resistance divided by total resistance. So this is the formula we need to use to calculate the value of I2 from the circuit. If suppose we are going for the calculation of I3, then again same, I3 is equal to total current into opposite resistance divided by total resistance. Okay, now everything is okay, but which resistance we need to take as opposite resistance from this particular network or circuit? Means simply just see here, in which branches current is dividing? R2 and R3. Yes or no? So R2 branch and R3 branch, only in these two branches only current is divided. Means we need to consider only these two resistances. So for example, I am going to calculate the value of I2 here. If suppose, then I2 is equal to, yes, total current means what? Just now we are calculated I1, that is I1 into opposite resistance. Means we are calculating the value of I2 from this circuit. It means current is divided in this branch and in this branch. We are calculating the value of I2 in this branch. It means definitely R3 is the opposite resistance to R2. And divided by total resistance means we need to consider only this divided, whatever the current which is divided in this particular branches, we need to consider only these two branches of resistances. Okay, so I1 into opposite means what? R3. Opposite means R3 divided by total resistance means only R2 plus R3. Now, by using this formula, we can simply get the value of I2, that is divided current I2 in this branch. If suppose we are going for the calculation of I3, then I3 is equal to total current I1 into opposite resistance means we are calculating the value of current in this, that means R2 is the opposite to this particular R3 resistance. That is I1 into R2 divided by R2 plus R3. Clear? So with the help of this formula, we are going to calculate the divided current in the electrical circuits. Okay, so this is the procedure we need to follow whenever we are going to calculate the values of currents which are divided in the circuits. Clear? So it's a very, very important concept in the electrical circuits. Okay, so thank you so much, and if you like the videos, then please do subscribe my channel, and if you like the videos, then please share with your friends. Thank you so much.